agenda.
With the fourth round of Brexit negotiations due to start on Monday, Theresa May's intervention was intended to break the stalemate between Britain and the European Union. Its chief negotiator, Michel Barnier, praised the speech as constructive, but asked for more detail. Another European official said it had left him even more concerned. Next week, too, French President Emmanuel Macron will announce his proposals for EU reforms, underscoring the bloc's determination to press ahead with a closer union that excludes the UK. Hosting the Finnish Prime Minister on Friday, he said that in Brexit talks, rules on the settlement of European Union citizens, the financial terms of Britain's departure from the bloc, and the question of Ireland must be clarified before other issues can be tackled. Member of the European Parliament and former leader of his UK Independence Party, Nigel Farage, branded Mrs. May's speech part of a great Brexit betrayal.
Her vision is that we leave the European Union, but we do so in name only. We stay part of all the current structures. What we do is we simply rebadge the status quo. I voted for us to be able to be competitive, to be global, to be free of European laws, and she shows no desire or no vision to be the kind of leader we need to take us on to be a global trading nation.
But British opposition leader Jeremy Corbyn said it sounded like the PM had listened to his Labour Party's recommendation that the UK needs a transition on the same basic terms to provide stability.